equality between men and women.
Maybe there's a way to break into this house.
Your blood is now mine!
Louise's father was determined to find and save her.
from Ascalon. I don't care.
How long are you going to keep me locked in here?
Miss Teasdale, are you all right?
How do you know my name? Who are you?
My name is Dr. Reed. I managed to track you down thanks to your father.
So my father really was looking after me. This man, this vampire, told me my father was dead. Is it true?
I'm afraid so, miss. I'm so sorry for your loss. But you are free to go, as your abductor is no more.
I suppose my jailer also killed my father, didn't he?
Thankfully, he did not search your father's corpse, where I found his notes describing where he might find you. You should read them.
I must find my father's body. He deserves a proper burial.
Goodbye, Miss Teasdale, and be careful. Until we meet again. You should return to a safer place, Miss Teasdale. What's more, I'm not sure you should see your father in his condition. He was savagely disfigured.
Thank you for your sympathy, Doctor. But I recently learnt to stare horror in the face.
Goodbye, Miss Teasdale. And be careful. Until we meet again.
worries me.
Good evening, Miss Teasdale. How have you been since you returned home?
Dr. Reed. Oh, thank God you returned safely from these awful streets. I was so worried about my father that I left without thanking you properly.
Please don't mention it, miss.
Good. I found him, you know. My dad. Or what was left of him. I think my abductor intended to do the same thing to me.
Why did your father feel guilty? He seemed so eager to welcome you back, as though he'd done something wrong.
The last time we saw each other, we had a terrible argument. I left the house and ended up in a pub. That's where the vampire met me. Dead drunk.
I see.
We argued a lot, me and Dad. But I always came home. I'm sure that's why he went to find me. He knew something bad had happened.
Your father never gave up on you. In the end, he risked everything to save the daughter he loved.
Yeah, that was my dad. Tough bastard, just like me. Even if I'd broken his leg, he would have gone looking for me.
What do you mean?
That last argument we had. It was more of a fight, actually. He slapped me and I kicked him hard in the balls.
Do you need my medical attention, miss?
I don't need your help, specifically. I can assure you there are many competent doctors around.
I have no doubt about it, but I'm offering you my help anyway.
All right then, but please leave me alone for now.
Goodbye, Miss Teasdale, and be careful. Until we meet again.
Why can't I forgive you, Father?